Yeah, it's a nice little performance. Hi everybody, and welcome to another Expressive E Osmose video. Now, I did a complete breakdown video of the Osmose synth a few months back, and since then you have had plenty of questions and comments regarding the Osmose synth, especially how to set this up to work properly with MIDI. So that's exactly what we're gonna deal with here today. And of course you're also going to hear some nice sound demos with the Osmose synth, so stay tuned and make sure you watch the whole video so you get to know how to work properly with the Osmose synth. Let's take the tour. If you're all new to the Osmose synth, this is a really expressive keyboard. It's unlike anything you played before when it comes to MIDI controllers. With the Osmose you have MPE and polyphonic MIDI. That means that we can bend notes differently and we can use aftertouch differently and separately on each individual note. So not only do you have a very large span for the aftertouch, which means that you can play very, very softly and get and we can also wiggle the keys sideways to get pitch bends. And this type of deep expression works for each individual key separately. So let me play a little cue here and let me know in the comments from which game this music belongs. Right, so let me know in the comments which game this theme belongs to. And as you can hear, this is like the perfect instrument to score something like the Dune movie. Okay, so let's continue and talk about the essential MIDI setup of the Osmose synth to connect it with your DAW. Okay, so there's a few different ways you can connect the Osmose to your DAW. The first and most obvious use case is to use the Osmose as a standalone synthesizer and connect it via the audio outputs from the Osmose synth to the audio inputs of your audio interface, and use the Osmose synth as a standalone synthesizer and just record the audio outputs. The internal synth engine of the Osmose synth, called the Eigen Matrix from Haken Audio, is extremely capable, so that's one natural way to connect and record the output from the Osmose synth. Right, but most of you probably want to hook up the Osmose synth via MIDI, and the great thing about the Osmose synth is that you have MIDI over USB, so forget about the MIDI DIN port and just hook up the MIDI USB cable from the Osmose synth to any available MIDI port on your computer. Okay, so the next step, how do we set up the Osmose synth within our DAW? Because it's not that obvious, because the Osmose synth feature two MIDI ports. You have MIDI port 1 and MIDI port 2. So we'll take a look at how to set this up in Bitwig Studio, because a lot of people have been asking about this setup. So first out, we go into the Bitwig dashboard settings and the controllers. Right, so like I mentioned, there's two MIDI ports on the Osmose synth, and depending on how you want to use the Osmose synth, maybe to control VST instruments, or if you want to control the internal synth engine of the Osmose synth, and send the MIDI to our DAW, and then from the DAW back to the Osmose synth to trigger the internal synth engine. And that's when we use MIDI port 2. So basically, set up MIDI port 1 if you want to control VST instruments, and instruments within your DAW or synths within your DAW, and you're going to use MIDI port 2 if you want to control the internal synth engine of the Osmose synth. So let's first take a look at the first scenario when we want to control a VST instrument within our DAW. So first you want to add a new controller, and we can select the keyboard plus 8 device knobs and press add. And then we're going to set the MIDI input to Osmose port 1. I know that sounds very weird, and it's because we get the same MIDI data to the same MIDI channel, and the different aftertouch or pressure data that we get from the different keys to the same MIDI channel. But like us, there's a solution to this problem by using an external controller script for the Expressive E Osmose keyboard. So you need to head over to the Expressive E website. I leave a link in the description to this page, and you need to install the Osmose controller script specifically developed for Bitwig Studio. There's a link to the controller script, which is basically a JavaScript file, and you need to put this file into the documents Bitwig Studio / controller scripts. Now the next time you boot up Bitwig Studio, you should see this Expressive E Osmose controller. So just activate that one, and Bitwig will set up this script automatically for you, and we can go just to the track, select the inputs here for the track, and make sure you select the Osmose external MIDI port 1. Because if this is set to all inputs, all the MIDI data from all the different ports that you have will be sent to this track at the same time. And as you can see, if I play a key, you get MIDI data both on MIDI port 1 and MIDI port 2. And you don't want both of these on the same track. You just want one of them. So select MIDI port 1 in this case. And we have the MPE working correctly. And as I mentioned, make sure you select this correct MIDI input port on the tracks that you want to use with the Osmose synth. So as you can hear now, we can have individual pitch changes on the individual notes. Okay, so the next step is to use a hardware instrument within Bitwig Studio to use the internal synth engine of the Osmose. So we're basically going to use the MPE MIDI from the Osmose synth, send it to our DAW for recording, and then send the output, the MIDI output back into the internal synth engine via USB. And get the audio from the internal synth engine back into our DAW. And that's when we use the hardware instrument. So let's add a new track. And let's add the hardware instrument. And we're going to set up the output port to Osmose port 2. And we're going to use keep channel, but we're going to activate use MPE. And we need to select an audio input. And in this case, I'm using the stereo input 7 on my Sennheiser audio interface. Now to get the hardware instrument to work properly here on the Osmose synth, we need to do some adjustments on the internal MIDI settings of the Osmose synth. So you make a light press here on this M button. You need to go here and press this cogwheel button. Then we're going to use the first scroll knob and scroll to the MIDI I.O. Here we're going to set the external MIDI clock to a third USB play. And we're going to set the USB Haken mode to a third note play. And you want the Haken local control to be off. The reason to set the Haken local mode to off is that we don't want the Osmose synth to respond directly to the MIDI data that we play. We want it only to respond to the MIDI that's sent from the DAW back into the Osmose synth. Right, so that's the important settings here. And basically in any other scenario, you want to have the Hawken local control set to on to get the most expressiveness out of the Osmose synth. But basically in this scenario, when using the Osmose synth as a hardware instrument, you want to set the Hawken local control to off. Important, remember. Right, so finally, after all this setup, let's see how this works in a recording situation in our DAW. So let's press record and play some fun stuff here. Yeah, so nice little performance. Right, so if we go into the piano roll and zoom in a little bit, you can see that we have all these individual wiggling on the pitch bend for the different keys here. And if we look at the timbre, we have the timbre data, and we also have the polyphonic pressure. So let's play that back and hear all the glorious MIDI playback with all this expression sent back to the Osmose synth. Right, so that's all for this video. I hope you had a nice time, and if you have any type of questions or want to see more content here on my YouTube channel with the Osmose synth or any of my other instruments here in the studio, please let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching today. See you in the next one. Bye!